Welcome to the fifth episode of our restoration videos of our 1881 Steinway Centennial Model D in Burr Walnut Veneer. We're now at the point, as you can see, that we're going to restore the soundboard. You can see already many soundboard shims in there. And we're using a special kind of glue, which is in Germany called Fischleim. It would translate into fish glue, which is it's water-based, and it's a very, very strong glue that hardens crystal hard. So you can see the first shims are all worked by, and now we're gonna send the soundboard for the first time. We've got different tools to send the soundboard, bigger ones, smaller ones, so we can get to every corner and in every corner. You can see that here. There's just very, very little paint on the soundboard, which you can easily send off, as you can see it here. Yeah, and we haven't done all the cracks yet. You have to look and do some cracks first and the others in a second going to not damage the soundboard further. As you can see here, all the paint is gone and we put some other shims in. And after that, two or three people do control that we haven't missed anything before we go further on. We also dry down the soundboard with a heating system we put underneath the piano. We put blankets on the piano, so we get the humidity in the wood down to a level we wanted to, and then we shim and repair the soundboard. See? The next step then, after we done all the soundboard work, will be the bridge tops, which needs to be replaced. That's something you're gonna see further on in the video. And in there, there's also some complications involved. It's not so very easy to do the job. We had that before with a Model D similar age, but you're gonna see it shortly. So here our master technician is taking a look at the bridges together with our Daniel, who's also a piano technician. And we decide to renew the whole bridge tops. And then that's what I did speak in before about the bridge pins are in a state of oxidation, which makes it very hard to get them out of the bridge, because it's in there for 140 years, and it's not so very easy. But in the end, it will cause some damage on the bridge tops. But the bridge tops are damaged anyway, but we need to we make some kind of sketch of the bridge tops, so we know about where all the pins have to be. You're gonna see that later. some more soundboard shims, and here you see it's very hard to get them out, but in the end it works and we get all the bridge pins out. Yeah. Some work. It's gonna be something like 500 of them, I think, or 400 of them. Pin by pin, handwork. And it takes a while. See? But you also see the cracks and the originally damaged bridge tops. So that couldn't have stayed that way, so we have to do the work and renew the bridge tops. Pin by pin is removed now. When you once know how to do it, it starts to get or to work better. And they're all gonna be removed. That's what I know by now, because the piano is in a perfect state now. But we keep you informed and subscribe our channel, give us a thumb up, call us for any question. Bye.